G'day guys, back again. This time around, I thought we could have a look at a 1/24th scale Masterbox kit, and we'll give it a go. We've got a Tiberius, Constellation, Hackington 3. Can they make the title a little bit longer? I thought it looked quite nice. Mostly also because of the fact that it's got a mask on its face and it's pretty much fully covered in armor. So there's really no flesh to paint on this one. And I quite like the stance. And just the weapon as well. A little shot of the back of the box, if you like to pause it. A little bit further down, you can see the other figures in the range. Let's have a look inside. So here's pretty much the instructions. And the funny thing about this kit is, they seem to show you the side shots of the face, even on the box art, but they don't actually give you a front-on picture of the actual face itself, which is pretty interesting. Again, they seem to love writing little stories on these figures. Like my Iron Man kit, you will get the moulding line all the way down the parts, which will take a fair bit of time to clean up. And probably my biggest issue with this kit is this leg here, where the actual moulding line, if you've seen my Forge World Space Marine video, this moulding line is problematic in the fact that although you get the line there, the jump from the piece to the next piece is huge. So this piece corner here should really be matching up with this piece here, and you can see the actual drop in the alignment of these two halves is absolutely massive. So pretty much what I'll have to do there is find the bottom layer here and pretty much cut most of that off and then come down from this angle as well. Get that in position again, is coming all the way through there. I have to keep doing that until these two areas basically meet up nice and flat. Here's the part I've given it a little bit of a clean up, and the good news is it doesn't seem to take too badly to a hobby blade. Some of the other rubbery type kits that you can buy, they sort of don't like the blade at all. When you try and start cutting through the little mold lines, they seem to be almost rebounding off the hobby blade, and almost you have to almost peel it off just about to act, and it pretty much wrecks the kit a bit. This one's not too bad. It's firm enough that you can take it off with a hobby blade, but you will be spending, if you want to be fussy about it, probably about an hour, I would say, to 2 hours, you know, my time, cleaning up this kit, getting it ready to actually put some paint on it. And that's not taking into account if there's any other serious bad mold lines or misalignments. You can see on the other leg, it's not as bad. The mold line, this doesn't have that big drop there, which is interesting. But and then obviously you've still got the lines going all the way down most parts. Now apart from the mold line issue, the actual detail on the kit is done okay. I wouldn't say it's 100% crisp and sharp, but it's not terrible. And I think it'll build into a reasonably nice kit once it's built up. Barring any fit issues that we might have. The face on this kit is actually quite impressive for a cheap vinyl PVC kit, but I'm going to put the mask on it anyway, and hopefully they'll fit well. I will probably attach the mask on this video just so you can have a look. So on the mask, that they don't show you on the box art or the instructions front on, here it is here, and you can see hopefully on the right hand side, you can see the whatever the air ventilator things is, or whatever these little vents are here, is done quite nicely. You can see all the holes, and then on this side, it's not executed as well as the other side. So you'll have to put a little drill in there or a pin vise to clean or a pin or something to clear those out a little bit. The weapon itself is done again reasonably okay. You can see the trigger there is not too bad. The actual mold lines, again, you have along the gun, which is going to clean, you're going to need to clean up a bit. The end of the barrel isn't hollowed out or anything like that, so you'll need to, if you want to be fussy, hollow that out a little bit. But the actual design of the weapon I think is quite nice. You get a couple of pouches. They seem very basic to me. They're not exactly full of detail or anything like that. I think they could have put a couple of little clips on the end or buttons or something on the end of the straps there or up the top just to add a little bit more detail to it. It looks like that was a bit of a last minute option, just slapping those things on. But you can see the mold lines around the kit. You'll need to clean up, but at least there's nothing over the face if you're wanting to leave the mask off the face. And also the attachment joints are reasonably large on these kits, so you've just got to be careful when you're actually taking them off. A couple of the guards, I don't know if these are the knee guards or the shoulder pads, there's some up here as well, but they do have a little bit of texturing on them. The best part of the kit, apart from the face, is the actual torso. Like the Iron Man kit, there's a lot of detail, seems a little bit sharper, a little bit more attention paid to it by the looks of it compared to some of the other pieces. So I've started putting this kit together, and my main issues so far with this kit is pretty much the alignment of parts. Now you can see over this side, this sort of detail here that comes around lines up. This is pretty messy here, but that's going to be saved by putting the MO pouches over the top there. And over here, it's not too bad. I wouldn't say it's a great fit, especially for a kit that's pretty new. But then over this side, this is where the problem starts. This alignment was way out of whack. So was this, and up the top here. So I could get a little bit of the belt aligned, but when I started aligning the belt, this wasn't aligned, and the other parts weren't aligned. And when I tried to align the shoulder up properly, this became really out of whack there. So I've got to say, for the actual production or molding of this kit, I'd be giving it a pretty good 5 out of 10. Given it's a brand new kit, and this shouldn't be that hard to put together. This shouldn't be that hard to align parts in this day and age. So that's pretty tacky, which is a real shame, because I'd actually say that it's quite a nice kit once it starts going together. And it's just really the production or the molding process that's really let it down. I'm sure the actual original prototype of this was fantastic. Now, another nice thing they have done here is they've done a little gap in the shoulder joint there. A little shoulder guard goes in, and they do have some nice little markings on that as well. And they've got a little indentation or a little bump there that goes into there. And again, that might be a bit of the saving grace, that this bit here, if I can actually get it on, may again hide some of that join line up the top there. But there's going to need to be a bit of putting done on it. I wasn't very happy when I was slapping it together just how the parts were going together, but given that most of the really bad areas are going to be covered up by other things, it sort of gets most of the issues sorted. But I'd be saying, if you were going to put this in a model show, as in trying to compete with it, you're going to have to spend a fair bit of time tidying up some of these lines and gaps. So it's not going to be a quick Tamiya build, that's for sure. I'll whack the head on there. The shoulder guard here is going to save a lot of the ugly gaps there, but you can still see up here there's a bit of a cleanup that you're going to have to do. Well, on my kit anyway. So here you have the figure here, and I've put the mask on. And as you can see, it's turning out to be quite a nice little figure. You see I've still got to clean up quite a bit of the lines on it. And now if you're just a general modeler that likes building kits and displaying them on your shelf, that's not going to be a problem. I'll just put this other little MO pack on here. Around that side of the waist. And I'll put his arm on as well. So without placing the hands in, because I actually want to paint this before I actually glue the hands on or anything like that, it actually looks pretty cool. Now I'll just show you what I'm talking about as well. You can see this molding line coming down here. But hopefully you can see also just the misalignment in the part here. I mean, this part here is almost 1 to possibly 2 mil hot in difference. So obviously you can get a knife and you can cut that across there and just sort of change the angle a little bit to join those two parts up. But as I said, for a new kit, a reasonably new kit, you shouldn't really be having to do that. Well, the only saving grace to this kit is that it's a pretty cool character, and it was only $20 Australian. If they were charging $50 or $49 for this kit and trying to pump it out as something extra special, I'd be pretty frustrated when I bought it. But just for the price, they just get away with it. This is pretty much the best I can do, just having a blue tacked in. And as you can see, the end result ends up being a very nice little figure. I do like, I haven't put the little hip armor on there, if you like, which will go on here. But other than that, it'll end up turning out to be a pretty cool little figure, especially with that weapon. It's a very cool weapon for the size of the figure. And the only thing that lets it down is the actual manufacturing of the figure itself, the mold lines, the misalignment, and all the cleanup you have to do. I mean, apart from that, if Masterbox actually got their act together and actually did a better job on cleaning this up, so it was a very quick, this could be a very fast kit to put together, and it would turn out to be very nice. If that was the case, I'd probably be giving this kit probably close to an 8 or 9 out of 10. The reason why you wouldn't get 10 out of 10 is just the actual detail on the figure isn't as sharp as what it could be. But because of the process of the way they've manufactured this kit, it's going to get... I'm going to give it a 6, and that's been kind. But the overall look of the kit is very well done. Anyway, guys, hope you liked having a look at that. Now I've got to get on with the painting. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.